I tried some Geeetech. See, because it's got all the E's. Geeetech Filament. This is their high-speed PLA. It's just an orange color. I had hoped this would actually be a little bit more orange. I'm still kind of happy with how it came out, but I just printed a few things to test it. I don't like the color, but I am going to check out some of their other colors in the high-speed PLA. That said, let's take a look at it. The Benchy came out pretty good. There's a little bit of stringing. I did dry this for 24 hours at 50 Celsius in one of my dryers. And I am very pleased with how Benchy came out. Really good quality. I printed this little Buddha. That was just a file that came with one of my printers. And again, he turned out pretty good. This is just where I went in and cleaned it up a little. And I just need to take a torch to that to get rid of the white. Pretty good. I needed a funnel for refilling my desiccant bottle when I dry the desiccant. And I printed two of these actually, and they came out pretty good. I hid the seam inside so you don't see it. Very sturdy. The PLA feels good. It's got a good, you know, sturdiness to it. It's not brittle. And then I made this pumpkin bucket. I actually blew this up some. The file I got was a little diminutive, and I wanted something kind of big. And I mean, it came out great. It just came out great. There was something weird going on here at the base. I don't think that's the fault of the PLA. The printer I did this on is my least favorite printer. And for some reason, at about that layer height, it always seems to do weird stuff. And it did it here. So don't take that as being a problem of the Geeetech. Everything came out fine. I did mess up with the seam a little. I had it placed on the file placed like that, so the seam's not really where I want it, and you can kind of see it. But I don't think you guys will notice it. I just know where it's at because I've kind of obsessed over this thing. And yeah, I really like this filament. This is a quick video. Geeetech definitely gets some thumbs up for me. I'll have links in the description and sticky comment for it. I'm sold. It's not my favorite PLA, but as I'm sure you're aware, there's these brands that have colors, and they don't have the colors you want always, so you kind of got to go elsewhere. And, you know, Geeetech has some colors that I haven't seen in my preferred brands. So, yeah, I'm definitely going to pick up more. I bought two spools of this orange. I don't know what I'm going to do with the other one, and I still have, I don't know, 50, 100 grams left on this. And it'll probably just get vacuum sealed and sit around until I need it for something that shade. It's definitely not the pumpkin orange I was hoping for. It's more like the inside of a pumpkin. But yeah, thanks for stopping by. I know this one was quick. I'm just going to keep these filament ones quick when I do them because there's no sense drawing it out. I didn't feel like I needed to get the microscope out for this one either. Visually, with the naked eye, everything looks great. I'm very satisfied with it. And I'll see you guys in the next video.